So, Rob, you're on Twitter, correct?
Sometimes.
Make sure y'all follow us on Twitter. Why don't people follow us on Twitter?
I actually dreamed about that last night. In my dream, I was on Twitter tweeting stuff and interacting with people and building like a cool community. Then I woke up and found out that no one follows me.
Yeah, I felt that. We be saying stuff on there. But anyway, I found this tweet that I wanted to bring up to y'all. I will literally never believe your 20s are meant to be the prime of your life. The years immediately following your adolescence, when you're entrenched in battlefields of unlearning, healing, and growing. Yeah, right.
Sorry, is this too loud?
This girl's saying, girl, I'm assuming. She can't believe that those are supposed to be the prime years of your life. You have to go through battlefields entrenched with learning. And I was like, dear God, ain't your 20s your prime? Why have the victim mentality with something like that?
And what even is your prime? Like, I think everyone's prime is different.
Your prime can be anything you want it to be, but I'm in my 20s, all this unlearning I have to do. Aren't there people in Somalia who don't even have books? Like, they just want to learn something. And you're over here, oh, all the unlearning I have to do. I have chosen to look at life with the glass half full. I'm pushing for people to, and I do this myself because I often find myself doing this, having a victim mentality. Like, oh, woe is me. Oh, I'm in my 20s. It's so difficult. Like, yeah, there's so many challenges that come with every period of your life, but why not look at things through an optimistic lens? You're the youngest, low-key most attractive you'll ever be. You got energy, college friends and stuff, massage chairs.
Well, not everyone, I wouldn't say.
Not everyone has massage chairs.
I'm kind of just stealing it from Noah right now. I didn't even ask him. I'm just using it.
I'm just like the most positive person I know. And I'm just trying to push positivity.
I think you get further in life by being positive.
Instead of labeling yourself entrenched in a battlefield of unlearning.
It's easier to complain and be negative, I think. So See what happens when you try to be more positive.
Because this person said that it's a battlefield of growing. I love growing. Growing pains. I f***ed that shit. I actually didn't when I was growing up. No, you're tall.
I definitely had that. Why can I be in this conversation? Well, I used to watch like the videos back in the day where I would stretch, like be 2 inches taller. And I was like, if you do it while you're in puberty, you could get taller. It didn't really work, but I did eat enough vegetables. I know that. I was eating very bad foods all throughout my life. My knees at night, like they would feel weird, like locked, or I'd wake up like sore. Like it's not like, ah, terrible, but it's like a, ooh, like a feeling like.
The question is, did Rob have that?
He went from this.
I did get taller than one from when I was 8, Ryan.
From 8 to 15, I'm sure Rob felt something.
Rob is 5'10".
No, I'm 6 foot, Ryan.
So did you like feel yourself like,
I did it. I kind of just gradually grew maybe, and then I stopped.
On Twitter, there's a new surgery. It was like, my first successful patient. He went from 5'3 to 5'9. But the problem is, they can't extend your arms.
Fuck.
So, like, he looks like SpongeBob. At the prom date, he had long ass legs, but his arms are like stuck here now.
It's $80,000 for each leg.
Damn, not each leg.
I can only do one right now.
Walking around like.
Cause it was originally meant for the people that when you were born, like some people have a shorter leg than others.
I seen some guy on TikTok that has a short leg, but he just has one shoe that's really tall.
Kinda dope. Did you do that surgery though?
Nah, I'm good with what I got.
This happy guy that was like showing that he could still run after, he looked fucked up.
Oh shit.
They break the leg, they open it, and then they put the rod in, and then your bone will just fill in the gap.
Oh shit.
Could that work for your arms though, technically? But you have to every night put this magnetic machine?
Not every night.
Every night for the whole 6 months.
Okay, only 6 months.
What?
6 months of torture.
Yeah. 6 months until the bone grows back. Because you have to like get the bone to like come back up.
And this is making me think like.
They're doing that because they're not getting the girls they want. Being a 5'2 male, you look down as like not worthy or something.
Unless you're 6 foot, then I ain't talking to you. And then if I say, oh, I want a woman under this weight, you're a body shamer.
We have in preference. You're doing body preferences.
It's okay for them to have it. Yeah, people come in all shapes and sizes and, you know, preferences, whatever, whatever, but it's popular to morph your face and body and all this shit. I can understand maybe if your ears were like,
yeah, I'm about to say, like, some people could have noses where it's like, all right.
If you have, like, whatever, ear, nose.
Now there's people that are doing the paying $150,000 with, like, Justin Bieber.
Whoa, look at that shit, hold on.
Yeah, why did he pick the 2010 Justin Bieber?
Do you want people to go up to him and be like, JB? What's the point of doing that?
There's the one guy who wanted to be a K-pop star, and he was like, I identify as Asian, he's transracial.
You can do that now?
People have problems where they don't want to externalize and be like, not them. Like, I want to look like this person because I love him.
And then when you do such a drastic surgery, like imagine I got my legs extended, and then the pan down to the leg. Am I supposed to just act nonchalant like nothing happened? I walk around all tall? Something's different about Rob.
Like you would disappear for 6 months because you're not trying to hang out with people while you're like, yeah. So what's going on? Don't worry about it.
Hey, come and hang out. Let's go walk on the beach. I'm busy.
Ryan's like, Rob.
Wow.
And then you pop out 7 inches taller, but then your arms are still 5'9 length.
It's like the girls that claim to not get any lip filler or anything. And it's like, have you got any work done? No.
And then there was one woman that paid $100,000 to look like Kim Kardashian.
That's a girl?
She paid $150,000.
And where did that money go to? With the body modification and stuff, I feel like to a certain point, okay, I ain't going to do that. gotta live your life, but you've got pretty girls changing their shit.
There's girls removing their ribs on both sides just so they can have a smaller waist.
I need my lips bigger here. I'm like, no, you're good.
They look good. I mean, you worked at a place where they did that.
Yeah, I did. I've seen people come in and I'm like, you're gonna come in here again? You were here last week. So how much more are you gonna fill up? But then people would come in.
I need to get it dissolved.
Does it go away?
You think it goes away. So it's like, I need more. And then you get addicted and then you look like that.
Let's say it's like a white girl really has no lips. And then I have absolutely no problem. Do it. Then I think it becomes a slippery slope when you're like, I could use a little bit of here. Your friends and you're looking on Instagram and I should have a little cleaner jaw.
Same way if I buy the Balenciaga shoes, I'm like, dope, I got them. And then I'm like, do you need the Balenciaga shirt now? Oh, I don't have the Balenciaga. I don't have the Mary jeans.
I guess it's crazy to just see how common it is now to get Botox. 17, 18 year old girls are getting fillers and eyebrow lifts and this and that. When back then it was so taboo.
I had not discovered that shit until I came to LA with the face fillers and shit.
18 year old girls getting boob jobs. I'm like, you haven't even fully developed.
Give it a few years.
At least 25.
It's the butt thing that I think
I've successfully seen a good BBL. That could just be me.
Just work out.
Do some squats. Well, because even if you get the butt, don't you still have to work out to maintain it? Like, I don't know.
I guess it's easy for us to just say, just work out. People that get this have their reasons and...
Well, why work out when you can just snip, snap, cut, cut? But that's a dangerous surgery too. That's like deadly and shit.
Yeah.
I remember it was saying like 1 in 3,000 people die. Don't quote me on that, but...
He gave me a bowl of Cheerios and said, one of these will kill you. I'm not eating that bowl of Cheerios.
Yeah, I'm saying all this to say, do whatever the fuck you want. I don't give a fuck. But it's a slippery slope sometimes with your self-image and stuff. And that's why I'm okay with being ugly. I don't care.
I can't wear makeup. I get this every day.
Yeah, that's why I'm fine with the way I look because, I don't give a fuck. I'm stuck with this.
So I'm gonna be showing Noah how to get an extra hour of motivation. I'm about to use this right now because I'm tired, but I have to go write something.
I have been editing all day.
So I'm gonna show him our guy, Jason Capital.
Hey, can you risk 10 seconds right now? Because if you can, I can make you motivated. I wanna show you how I get an hour of extra motivation every single day. I felt so f***ing tired and I didn't know what to do. At some point, I literally got pissed. I got angry and I said, f*** this. And for some reason, I started going like this.
What the fuck?
Wait a second.
Did he just bark? Did this guy just say I've been down like a pure pissed? And the only thing I do to get out of this was.
And when I barked, instantly, I had energy. I had way more energy. I felt super motivated and I got shit done. And in less than 9 months, I went from zero to millionaire.
No shade to this guy. Yeah. I bet you he's a successful, nice.
I thought that was a parody, to be honest.
Like, there's different sciences to making your mood better. If you fake smile, you'll actually potentially be actually happy.
Yeah, I took a teaching class in high school and they said every 30 minutes, like, if you just stand up, your oxygen levels go up, your brain's more alert. So our teacher would remind us to be like, oh, get up. We stand up, boom, maybe walk around the class and back down. And you're like, oh, I can focus again.
Yes. Taking a 5 minute walk.
Or just.
That's funny as fuck.
Imagine like I took that to heart. Every day you just like,
yeah, you hear me.
I'm like, Ryan gonna get some shit done today. I heard the barks.
Is Rob in his room right now? Let me call him real quick. Is there anyone else up there right now? So you can't bark right now? All right, let us know if that worked for you. Have y'all ever been so like, what do I do right now?
Task for the day.
He's already organized.
Still don't have enough. Good to go now.
What would your go-to sound be?
I don't think I'd even need to make a noise. I kind of just click in my head like, oh, time to just stay focused.
Bark into your pillow. And he's not saying bark and then you'll become rich. He's just saying that was something that worked for him.
I don't think that's gonna work for me at all.
No one's going on him. They said, I love this. Put Wolf in the comments. Bro, every idea is crazy until it's not anymore.
If Justin Bieber said in 3 interviews, every time I bark, I can do a successful studio session. Imagine how many people would actually start barking.
It's only lame when a random person does it, but then when a cool person does it, it's cool. I bark now.
We're barkers.
Uber, getting into a car with a stranger, taking them somewhere. Oh, that'll never work. That's insane. Stay open-minded and bark when you want extra motivation.
Be you.
Be you. I don't care what you're doing. If you're barking or screaming or shitting or whatever you gotta do.
Better get back to this.